successful growing here in the Philippines. The Malabar tamarind was once known as the less popular cousin of the mangosteen, yung binibenta sa MX3.
Yeah.
Right? In fact, may ibang supplement na nakita ko sa America, binibenta rin Cambogia, pero yung picture ito.
Yeah.
Because may ingredient dito sa mangosteen na very effective, which is why MX3. Ang ganda, di ba? Binibenta MX3. Very popular. Why? Because we have mangosteen in the Philippines. So, pinamote nila. Maganda ang mangosteen. Pero, yung level niya, mas mataas. Ito. But we don't have it. So, ito yung pinopromote nila. Right? But now, nutritional supplements containing extracts of Garcinia cambogia have become the rage, touted for their ability to curb appetite and prevent weight gain. Marami siyang nagagawa, but most popular siya for controlling body fat. It ripens to a red or yellowish fruit about the size of an orange lung, but resembles yung pumpkin or yung ating squash. Now, traditionally, ginagamit siya sa stew, sa mga soup. Because, not just for the flavor, but because for health reasons. Chutneys or curries, and sometimes as an aid for stomach problems. Traditionally, mga traditional healers ginagamit nila for digestion problems. Ulcers, indigestion, ginagamit ang cambogia. But in the late 1960s, scientists identified a substance in the rind or the rind of the fruit called hydroxycitric acid or HCA, which has attractive qualities. HCA. Yung HCA na yan, naging sigat na sigat. Ito nung when I was teaching pa lang sa 80s, nagtuturo ako sa gym, ano na alam namin yung HCA? Hindi namin alam galing sa fruit na Garcinia cambogia. Alam na namin, nakabote yan eh. But it was so popular in the 80s, ang daming binibenta because of the hydrocitric acid, right? Sales of fat burners were high because during the 80s, yung mga action heroes, Sylvester Stallone, one of them, Arnold Schwarzenegger, puro malalaking katawan. Lahat ng pumupunta ng customer ko dati sa gym, gusto magpalaki ng katawan. They would come in and say, kailangan ko mag-ano, gusto ko maging malaki, gusto ko maging, sabi ko, bodybuilder. Hindi naman, pero mas malaki. I want to be big. So people will get big. Now the problem with becoming big, ito yung totoong style sa bodybuilding. It's like sculpting. You have to have a big amount of material to be able to sculpt it the correct shape. So ang ginagawa ng isang bodybuilder, meron yung tinatawag na bulking up season. Nagpapalaki siya. He eats and eats para lumaki. Muscles, everything, but also tumataba din, which is why you can see the difference. By the time malapit na yung competition, kailangan makita yung katawan niya, magda-diet na siya. He will start changing his diet. Ayan, mag-shift siya into low carb. Pupunta sa low carb diet, more protein, and then he will start using HCA to cut. Yung tinatawag yung nagka-cuts. Kaya yung terminology sa mga bodybuilder, you may cuts, because ito smooth, yan yung may cuts na. Parang shape na talaga yung katawan niya. Right? Yan. Now this became very, very popular in the 80s because halos lahat ng action star, malalaking katawan. So lahat ng tao gusto ko na rin maging action star, malalaking katawan. Kaya nakapasok ako sa ano, kasi galing ako sa pagka-fitness instructor. Tapos ang dami kong kliyente kasi ang daming artista yung mga bida, kailangan mag-workout. Kaya kumukuha ng tips. And this one of the most popular products for cutting and burning fat was a product called Hydroxycut. Hydroxycut was named after the hydroxycitric acid na nasa cambogia, right? Now, medyo nagka-terror, may mga natakot, because may namatay. And he was using Hydroxycut. A 19-year-old boy namatay siya, nagka-heart issue siya from using hydroxycut. Kaya may medyo natakot ang mga tao. And because of the name hydroxycut, na-connect nila sa hydroxy citric acid, which when they did studies, mali pala. The ingredient that was responsible because nakaka-palpitate was guarana. Guarana is being sold pa rin in some countries as a weight loss metabolic booster. Yan ay bawal na sa FDA sa Amerika. They were able to link that with why namatay yung bata. Not with HCA. Okay, so, baka marunong, you may hear some wise guy sabi niya, ay, may namatay. Hindi sa HCA yun, kundi sa guarana, which is different. Hindi pinagbawal na yung guarana.
Wala na.
Wala na ang guarana. In fact, hydroxycut is now being sold again, pero talaga may nakatatak sa ilalim. No guarana. Dapat Tagalog nga, wala na, wala na. Sorry, I did it again. Oops, I did it again. Now, nabuhay uli itong Cambodia, Garcinia Cambodia, because in 2012, ito si Dr. Julie Chen talked about Garcinia Cambodia on the show of Dr. Oz. Si Dr. Oz is a famous TV doctor na nag-guest pa yan sa Oprah. Who, Oprah, kilala niya si Oprah Winfrey? Yes. Dati di ba nagkakaproblema siya sa weight din, pumapayat, tapos tumataba ulit, pumapayat. Now, steady na. So she was able to discover proper diet and proper supplements na. Pinag-usapan nga ni Dr. Oz, promoted Garcinia Cambodia on the Oprah Winfrey Show. Talaga sabi niya, with all the studies and all the scientists who get excited about this, impressed siya. You can see that si Oprah may mga problema, yung mga new pictures niya, ganun na. Right? Ganda. Kasi may picture na nandun, may pose na ako. Four-week control ang ginagawa niya. A lot of people, including yung ating instruction manual, says Cambodia is a fat blocker. Hindi siya fat blocker. It is a fat formation blocker. It prevents fat from forming. Diba? Kasi some people say, pag inom mo itong Garcinia, pwede kang kumain ng tama. Okay lang. Ngayon, unang-una, the problem is, nga sabi natin, eating fat does not make you fat. In fact, you need fat to burn fat. Our body, that's why our body was made to make fat. Eating fat doesn't make you fat, but it can give you problems like high blood pressure. Right? But we also do not eat fat normally. Hindi natin kinakain yung fat because nakakasawa yung lasa, di ba? Sino ba dito kumakain ng adobo? I mean, tapos binubuhos yung sauce sa rice. Ang sarap ng sauce, di ba? Puro mantika. Correct? But di ba remember, sinabi natin, one portion of rice, half cup. Right? If you have half a cup of rice, hindi mo ibubuhos ng ibubuhos ng ibubuhos. Pero if you have two cups of rice, kulang yung lasa. Fat. Yung mga fats have their own control na ayaw ng katawan natin. Even the taste doesn't like it. Hindi mo rin kakainin yung butter pag walang bread. Correct? Hindi. Butter, sarap. Diba? Our body has its own way of telling you not to eat that. So, you will also be able to determine pag sobra na. So, don't worry about fat, right? It does not block fat, it blocks fat formation. Ginagawa niya, hinahara niya yung citrate lyase converts excess carbohydrates and sugars into fatty acids, cholesterol, and triglycerides. Itong citrate lyase, which is in the Cambodia, converts excess carbohydrates and sugars into fatty acids, cholesterol, and triglycerides. Ito triglycerides, so siya na naman ito, triglycerides. Yan yung blood fats. Diba? Yan yung blood fats. So, yun ang kalaban mo. high blood, heart disease. But again, pansin niyo, converts excess carbohydrates and sugars into fats. So yan, IBD fats. It's not fat into fat. Right? So ano nangyayari? Yung ibang tao, hindi muna kakain yan, hindi muna kakain. Kakain na lang ako ng fries. Diba? And cookies. Diba? Kasi diet ako eh. Diba? But it converts it into fatty acids, cholesterol, and triglycerides. So we've been eating the wrong types of things. So yan ang nagagawa ng kabonggiya. You take it 30 minutes to an hour before your meal so that it will stop itong citrate lyase or lyase para hindi siya magpo-form ng fats. Ito parang diet ng tamad. Kasi mo, sarap. Sarap, adobo pa naman yun. Parang alam mo, favorite kong adobo. I can eat it every day. In fact, pag nagluluto ka ng adobo, ako 5 kilos ang niluluto ko. Tapos nasa freezer. Di ba parang pag gutom ka, pagpunta ka nun, sandok mo lang. Tapos yung microwave mo lang, ulam na. And, pag pinato mo sa salad, masarap. Di ba? Kuha ka ng lettuce, kuha ka ng mga gulay-gulay, tapos konting adobo on top. May protein ka na, may gulay ka na, hindi ko rin yung number rice. Right? Ito yung secret pala. If you're going to remove rice, or lessen rice from your diet, you must replace it with something else. So it's either that the mo yung gulay, diba kung ginawa mo half cup of rice, tinanggal mo, dapat may half cup of gulay na replace. Diba para hindi mo hahanapin yung quantity. It is an appetite suppressant. Ito yung problema. When you take your kambogya 1 hour before, may tendency na biglang 2 hours later, hindi ka pa kumakain because hindi ka pa gutom. Right? But, dapat i-check mo yung time. You should take food like medicine. Kung anong oras ng kain, kumain ka. Whether you are very hungry or not. If you're not very hungry, kumain ka ng konti. Right? Because if you do not eat on time, parang gabot yan, di ba? Pag may prescription ka, may oras. If you don't eat on time, by the time you feel hungry, it's too late. Do not wait to be hungry because when you're hungry, it's too late. Your body will tell you to eat and eat and eat. Never mind kung ano yan, yung buong kalabaw, pwede na. Tapos gutom ka pa rin. You will eat and eat. So do not wait to be hungry. When it's time to eat, you take your kambogya, then you wait the appropriate number of minutes, then you eat. Just eat the right quantity. At magagawa mo yung sinabi mo, happy-happy lang. Boost metabolism. It balances our body's chemical reactions to have a faster energy burning system. Lowers blood cholesterol. Improve your immune function. Sinabi nga natin kanina, di ba? Wala dito sa kwarto tulad kasi itong Pasko. Now yung system nga, because it blocks fat formation, your body burns fat. Your body burns fat. Alam niyo bang best exercise for burning fat? Anyone want to guess? Walking. Yan yung tinatawag nilang slow burn. The slow burn. Because when you do a fast, explosive exercise, it's what's called anaerobic. And it uses glucose for energy. Susunugin niya yung glucose sa cells mo, in about 5 minutes time, ubus na yun. And then hinihingal ka na because your body is looking for more energy. But when you go slower, at a slower pace na continuous, your body burns fat for energy, hindi glucose. So if you walk and walk and walk, yung makuwari, pupunta sa Green Hills from here. Ibig sa mag-jeep ka, so you will walk. Eh, papawisan ako eh. Di ba nga so weird na ako eh? Papawisan ako eh. Eh, normal yung pawis eh. Di ba? You walk slower. You walk slower, and you walk there. Just doing that, adding extra walking, everybody can walk, you will burn fat. Right? Ito. Wala siyang strenuous program na ginawa niya, very light program niya. Just using kambogya. Week 1, week 4, week 8. 2 months. Okay? And it's convenient. Di ba yan yung mga binibenta noon? If you go to any supplement store now, you can find HCA under different names, no? Different names, binibenta nila. Tapos yung dosage nila, ibang klase. Capsule form. 1, 2, 3, 4. Usually, if you look at Hydroxica, the instructions niya, take 12 capsules. Yung minimum 12 capsules. Twice a day. Diba? So 24 capsules ka na. Alright? Two doses yan. Kaya mabenta, kumikita sila dyan because they make them take so much. Iinumin ang iinumin. Not everybody likes capsules. Yung sa atin, drink it lang. Masarap pa. May great flavor pa.
Yes.
And sweetened with stevia. Tapos napaka-complicated, diba? One sachet in a glass of water. Hirap. Drink 30 minutes to 1 hour before a meal. Mahirap din. Right? So yan yung difference niya. We have a convenient thing, you can take it. Some people, sinasabay nila. They take it during. Some will take half a glass and then continue the other half while eating. Pero, other way, busin mo muna yung one. Wait 30 minutes. Well, tapos na pala. At yan ang ating Cambodia and our dahil doon, ay, thank you.